Alhamdulillah, this program has so far discussed almost like everything. One of the concerns that Mansoor has raised is very valid. This is a question that I was also thinking, that there are currently many platforms available. For example, we have Council to take care of the political action. We have Iqra to take care of the education, and there are many other institutes as well. And so what is the need for a new platform? I think that is the, and there are many other youth programs that the youth can go and join those programs. So what is the need of a new platform? I think this World Council for Muslim Interfaith Relations is an international platform, and this is the time that we are setting up here a US chapter. So having this platform, the advantage that we will have is that we will be able to work internationally while representing, taking care of the and Islam, and we, as Dr. Wasiullah Khan says, the buzzword is globalization. So I think this is the time. Yeah, we should be focusing on the local issues here, living in the United States, Chicago, and then the United States. But we cannot just living in the United States without worrying the rest of the world. So I think that is the reason, and that is the core essence that we have. We are having this session here as an inaugural of this organization, and on which we are just focusing on four different issues. One is interfaith. I know there are many activities happening, except for the benefit of everyone, because I have these doubts as well, and I question myself that what is the need. So the need is that this is an organization that has already had a very rich experience working internationally, and with their guidance, Dr. Irfan is here, and with their guidance, and inshallah, and Brother Ahmadullah is here, and what is the brother's name in Texas?
Shaban.
Aslam Abdullah. Yeah, Aslam Abdullah. Las Vegas. Las Vegas. Brother Aslam Abdullah. These guys has been working for past 25, 40 years on this. Yeah, 10 years on these issues. So they will bring us, they will guide us. And this is the US chapter. And then nevertheless, so we will have, so that is the basic reason of establishing this platform. And through this platform, I think we will be able to guide not only the youth of Chicago or United States, but the Mansoor mentioned that some other youth are coming from the other part of the world. So we would be able to have our channels to reach those youth, you know, worldwide, inshallah. And as Dr. Mujahid Ghazi mentioned that this program, I had an honor to do the recitation in the beginning of this program. And particularly the reason we selected those verses, Surah Al-Imran, verse number, I think this is the time just to reflect on those certain verses. Those were just for the benefit of everyone who came or joined us late for any reasons, because the weather was not right, and this is Saturday. People have their other commitments as well. The meaning, the theme of those verses from Surah Al-Imran, verse 102 to 104, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun wa'tasimu bihablillahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu wazkuru ni'matallahi 'alaykum is kuntum a'da'an fa'alafa bayna qulubikum fa'asbahtum bi ni'matihi ikhwana وكنتم على شفا حفرة من النار فأنقذكم منها كذلك يبين الله لكم آياته لعلكم تهتدون ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون. These are the basic principles. I think what we discussed so far in this session is this. The base that we are here is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking and demanding us to have the God consciousness, that as Dr. Tasneema mentioned in her presentation, the way he has he has to be conscious, the way that we should acknowledge his presence in our life, and we shouldn't die until we become a Muslim. And there's a whole definition, there's a whole lot of explanation that's in different tafaseer. And the next verse is وَعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding us to come collectively, as Brother Rashid mentioned, that we all have to come collectively. This is the, as Brother Abbasi said, that this is the time that we should come and pledge ourselves to come and work collectively. So وَعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا and don't be divided. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to tell us that there is a blessing, there are so many blessings, and there are different verses in the Quran and different parts Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned that even though وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نَعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا, if we start wanting to start counting on the ni'mas of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will never been able to do it. But one of the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is particularly mentioning here is that this relationship, this feeling, human to human, Muslim to Muslim, and then that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that human beings were enemies, but He has implanted this seed of love in us, so and then He made us as a brotherhood. And كَذَلِكَ يُبَجِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ, and these are the signs, among the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we can be guided. And the last words that we recited, and Dr. Tasima also mentioned and explained in her presentation, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهُونَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, and this is also a commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that let there be a group of people who will invite, and I think this is wherever it is happening, we have council, we have many other, and I hope that we can have more organizations, but when, as an individual, we should join those organizations, and as an organization, those organizations should have a kind of network to get our agenda to the platforms that we would like to see. And why? Only then we will become the successful in this life and the life hereafter. And on this, I think Dr. Mujahid Ghazi, thank you so much for giving me this time.